Joining me today is Marie Lozito, who is running for the New Hampshire State Senate in District 5. Marie, I like to talk. First of all, thanks for being here.
Thank you very much for having me. I appreciate it, John.
When we have our sort of the politicians running for office, the first question I usually ask and devoting the first segment is a chance to get to know you, right, and how you made the decision to run, whether you've been in office before. Why are you running for this? And then just a little bit about your life that makes you the right person for people to for this position. So for the Senate, what is it? Why are you running? And who are you, I guess?
Who am I? Let's start with that first. Okay, I'm a registered nurse and a licensed massage therapist and a certified licensed reflexologist and a certified healing touch practitioner. I've been working in healthcare since 1966 when I was in the Future Nurses Club at high school and the local Catholic hospital. The nuns there would take members of the club, teach them how to be a nurse's aide, and have them work volunteer in the hospital. So I've been working in the hospital before Medicare was in effect. So I've seen a lot of changes in healthcare over the years. I've been a nurse and registered nurse for the last 40 years. I worked critical care and had my national certification in adult critical care I had the certification for about 9-10 years, and I worked in adult critical care for about 20. Now I'm working, finally, not working full-time. I'm working per diem at a hospital over the border in Vermont on the acute care nurse setting. And I have my own private practice with massage therapy and reflexology and energy healing. And so that's my background, okay?
And so why the Senate?
Well, I've always been interested in politics. I got interested when JFK was running and I was still in grade school and they were telling all this stuff about how the Pope was going to take over and run America if JFK won. I was like, that's not how this works. And it got me interested in politics. And I've been watching it and I've been active in politics, but never running for an office until after I moved up to New Hampshire. And in 2010, I ran to be a state rep. I lost by 40 votes. Actually surprised me that I had as many votes because I still had a very heavy New York accent at that time. And coming from New York and knowing how liberal New Yorkers tend to be, I wouldn't have trusted me if I didn't know me.
So and the race is during, right at the end of the baseball season. So if you're a Yankees fan, it's even harder to get a vote up here.
Forget it. It's very hard. But I ran because I was looking at what was happening financially in the state of Concord, and I was afraid it was going to go the way of several other states where they have such huge debts that they might as well go bankrupt soon. And I was like, no, they have to be more responsible with the money. They can't just run an $800,000 debt, and not in a two-year cycle. This is ridiculous. They can't do this. So I ran then on an idea of fiscal responsibility, and that's why I'm running now, too. I was approached. I had not planned on it. I was going to start having more time to myself because I was going per diem.
Per diem, you can say, no, I'm busy today. I can't come in.
Right. Schedule it ahead of time. Oh, you're short that day. I can do that one for you. And it'd be the first time as an adult that I haven't worked both a full-time job as a nurse and a part-time job in my own business or some other nursing job. And I was looking, the end of the summer is going to be so wonderful and relaxing. And then they came and spoke to me and said they needed somebody to run for the Senate. And I was like, well, I'd really rather take it easy and relax, goof off. But then I started looking at the voting record because my opponent has been a representative for 2 years in Concord. And I started looking at the voting record and I said, I don't want her in the Senate with that voting record. She's not what I consider fiscally responsible. So I said, yes, I would run, and that's why I am here.
So have you had a chance to talk to a lot of people, or we've got about 30 seconds left. Is there sort of one thing you're hearing from the campaign trail, if we can call a campaign trail in New Hampshire?
Well, it's a campaign trail, and it is talking to the people, and people are upset with taxes. They're very, an awful lot of people are really struggling to stay above water. As it is, things are getting more expensive. That hasn't stopped. Most people aren't getting raises in their jobs, cost of living or otherwise. a lot of people have lost their jobs. And the biggest thing is they're concerned about the money.
Okay. I got to cut you off here.
Okay, sure.
But when we return, we're going to continue our conversation. We'll focus on the money and the budget. So please stay with us.